Hello student, welcome back. This is Vasan Naik from Vastik channel. Today we will continue our discussion with the 8255 IO programming of microprocessor and microcontroller syllabus 17CS44 of 4th semester IS and CS. 8086 microprocessor, we know 8086 microprocessor can access external device through ports. This is done by using instruction, that is out and in instruction. Out instruction move the data from the accumulator to the output device. In instruction will get the data to the accumulator, either AL or AX, from the input device. So now the format of in and out instructions, you can see here the format of in and out instruction. In instruction, destination, source. So in instruction you will get the data, and the data is stored in AL. The other way of in instruction is where we mentioned port address in DX registers, and we will mention the DX register along with the in instruction. These two types of addressing method are called as immediate addressing mode, and other one is register indirect addressing mode of addressing ports. So similarly, this will applicable to outputting the data. Here you can see out data source. From the port data goes to, sorry, from the AL the data goes to output port. So we will see this one. Before that, since if you use 8 bit for the port, then 256 input port and 256 output ports are possible. If you use 16 bit, then 65536 input port and 65536 output ports are possible. So for input 8 bit port address, normally you use immediate addressing mode. That is, you can see here, like move AL 36H. I have moved the value 36H into AL register. Then directly I will move the value to the output port 43H from AL. This is called as immediate addressing. But for the 16 bit port, we use register indirect addressing mode. That means we will first move the address to the register, and after that we will move the data to AL register. From there we will move the data to output port. Here you can see, for example, this program is used to toggle switches. So here you can see the port address is taken in a DX register, then the data to toggle the switches, like 8 switches, to toggle the 8 switches, the data is something like this. This data is moved to AL, from AL it is moved to output port. Similarly, the data is moved AA, this is moved to AL, from AL it is moved to output port. So this will toggle the alternative switches, or alternative LEDs, I can say. So this is called as a register indirect addressing mode. So like in memory, you have seen memory addressing, memory address decoding. Similarly, IO port addressing, address decoding is required. So IO port address decoding and design, we use two ICs, especially these two ICs are called as latches and buffers, 74LS373, 74LS244. 74LS373 used for output latches, 74LS373 uses as output latches or buffer, and 74LS244 is for input latches or buffer. So we will see this, how this works. In this following diagram, you can see 74LS373 is used in output design. What is there in the 74LS373? Because when the data moves from the processor to the output device, this data gets weakened. So it is necessary to, in between, it should be latched and it should be old, it should be amplified. That is done by these latches, you can see here. So this latch 74LS373 contains nothing but D flip-flop. You have already know what is a D flip-flop. D flip-flop is nothing but it holds the data, it is a latch. So here you can see, here in the diagram it is shown only one D flip-flop, but this 8-bit 74LS373 contains 8 such type of D flip-flops to hold the data before going the data to the output side. It will hold the data, it will amplify the data, I can say. So now, how you can design, suppose you have written the instruction something like this. The value from the AL is moved to the output port 99. You have written the instruction something like this. Then how this 99 is decoded? This 99 is decoded, now how the data is moved. So that is, see the diagram, 74LS373. Here, one end of the 74LS373 latch is connected to input data and other end goes to output device. Just think like here, 8 LEDs are there, Q0 to Q7, 8 LEDs are there. Now, this device should be first addressed, decoded. The address of this device should be decoded. That is, address is 99. This can be done by the basic gates, 99. What is a 99? So let me use the pen here once again. 99 is nothing but 1001 and 1001. You can see here 1001 and 1001. So wherever 0 is there, there is bubble is there, there is inverter is there. So finally this becomes 1 and this will goes to this AND gate. And along with this one AND gate, here we have control signal. What is that control signal? We will see this one. What is that control signal? IO write. This control signal will tell the latch to decode and write the data. So this control signal controls the writing of data inside this latch. So this is IOW. So in this way, the address is decoded and the chip is activated, and whatever data present in the data's side of data or data bus on the system side will be moved into the latch, and from there it is moved into output device or LEDs, and the LEDs will glow. Now we'll work out with one more design. Show a design of output port with IO address of 31FH using a 74LS373. So this is 74373. It is connected to the input side and connected to the output side, as you know. And the address design, we have to think about the 31FH address design. So how 31FH works? First let us write 31FH in binary format. 3 is so we can write 3 something like this, 0 0 1 1, and next 1 0 0 0 1, then F, so 1 1 1 1. So here you can see here you can see this one. This is 1, this is 1, this is 1, this is also 1, and this is also 1, followed by 0, 0, 0, and 1, and 1. Rest of the bits are not shown here, anyway, that is 0. So output becomes 1, and this will control this latch. This is the design of IO device. We have studied the decoding design of memory address. So it is the decoding of IO address, please remember. Now, how you can decode input address? So you can see here input port design by using 74LS or LA244IC. This is referred as a tri-stated because when the data is coming in by way of the data bus, it must come in through a tri-state buffer. This is called as tri-state buffer. When the data comes in, it must come through a tri-state buffer. That's why it is referred as a tri-stated. So now how the input are designed here. So we will take 74LS244. So 74LS244, you see here, these are the switches. You think this is the switches and this is the output side. You think like this is the switches on the output side. This through the switches, the data comes into the system data bus. So from there, it goes to the AX or AL of the microprocessor. So now how this is designed? Here you can see the design. This is 1111. This is 1010. That is 01011111. So this design shows this is somewhat 5F. So this design is nothing but here you can see this design is nothing but 010. This design is 5F. So from the 4 to 5F, the datas are coming in and it will move to AL. So these are the switches. Based on the position of the switch, the data is moved into AL. But the address is decoded by this decoder, simple decoder. Now show the design of INAL9F. Show the design of INAL input. So show the design of INAL9FH using 74LS as a tri-state buffer. You know 74LS244 as a tri-state buffer for input. So as I said in the previous case, imagine this is the outside switches. Based on the switches position, this will give the data. So like if the switch is 1, so S0 is 1, then it will give 1, or S0 is off, it will give 0. So that data moves to the microprocessor, inside the microprocessor. Like now how this will be addressed, this chip will be addressed. Here you can see the design. This is, let me write here, this is 1. This is 1, this is 1, this is 1, this is 1, and this is 1, this is 0, 0, 1. So this is 9 and this is F. So the 9F, so the data moves through port address 9FH to the microprocessor. This is the design. So in the instruction, you have given something like this. With this port, the address moves into AL. So we have two things, two type of addressing scheme here. One is called as memory mapped I/O, other one is called as peripheral I/O or isolated I/O. With communicating with the I/O device using in and out instruction is referred as peripheral I/O or isolated I/O. Here you can see separate I/O addresses are there from memory in the peripheral I/O or isolated I/O. But in some new RISC processor, they don't have in and out instruction. They have something called as memory mapped I/O. For I/O operation, a block of the memory address itself used for the I/O operation. Here you can see block of the memory address is used for the I/O operation. That is called as memory mapped I/O. So now what is the difference between isolated I/O and isolated I/O and memory mapped I/O are a very, very important question from the exam point of view. Let me explain here in simple terms, but you have to write these explanations properly. So in isolated or peripheral I/O, isolated or peripheral I/O, in and out instructions are there. In memory mapped I/O, we have instruction that access the memory location. For example, you can see this one instruction, that instruction access the memory location. Here only A0 to A15 are decoded in isolated I/O, but in memory address, all the entire 20 bit addresses are decoded. And the signals used here are I/O read, I/O write, here memory read and memory right. This is limited to 65,536 input port. This is limited to 1 MB. Other than this, data should be moved to accumulator for any kind of operation in and out isolated peripheral I/O, memory mapped I/O. In memory mapped I/O, arithmetic and logic operation can be performed directly. The user can expand the memory to its full size without using any memory space for I/O device. Uses memory space address, which could lead to memory space fragmentation. All these are the important differences between memory and input out. That means, see, when you connect memory is also a type of interface to the microprocessor. How the memory is decoded, memory address is decoded, when you connect external device like peripheral device, like how that is that for the peripheral device, the address is decoded. That is the meaning of input I/O, this is isolated I/O device and memory mapped I/O device. Isolated peripheral I/O and memory mapped I/O. So I/O address for 8086 PC, you can see the various I/O address range for 8086 PC, old PC, 8086 architecture. For example, DMA controller makes use of this address. Then we have something called as 8042 keyboard controller that makes use of this address. Then we have parallel printer port that makes use of this address. Serial port makes use of this address. Prototype of card, suppose in older PC you could see like you used to have network card and some other type of card for applications and all. That type of cards are called as prototype of card. That will make use of this address range between 300 and 31F. So that is called as prototype card. Like nowadays everything comes on board, like most of the cards like interface and all on board. Earlier we used to have network card, separate PCI cards, etc. That type of card make use of address 300 to 31F. So then in address, there are two types of address decodings are there. One is called as absolute decoding. Second one is a linear decoding. In absolute decoding, all the address lines are decoded. It is called absolute decoding. And if only selected address pins are used for decoding, it is called as linear select decoding. Now, as I said, prototype of card makes use of 300 to 31FH address. How this will be decoded? So what is that prototype of card? The prototype of cards are separate card that plugged into the expansion slot of the PC. For example, interface cards are the prototypes of card, and that card makes use of IOR and IOW signals. So we can see here, simple logic gate as an address decoder for prototype of card. Simple logic gates, how we use simple logic gates. So 74LS373 along with the NAND gate, it works like address decoder for expansion slot where prototype of cards are connected. Here prototype of cards are connected and that is interfaced to this one. Prototypes of cards are interfaced to like this one, and this will decode the address of that prototype of card. So address range is 300H. So here you can see all these are zero except this one, except this is one and this is one. So all these are zero, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 8 is one and 9 is one. So here you can see this is one block, and here you can see 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 6, we have one more 7 here. This is one more block, and this is 1 and 1, this is 3, this is 0 and this is 0, this is 300. This is address is 300. 300 is decoded, and that goes to 74LS373. It is the latch for the output, latch for the outgoing data. So here the data comes from the data outgoing data. So here data is there, this end of the latch is connected to the system bus. From here data goes to output. And data also comes from the expansion slot also. So you can use the decoder 74LS138 address decoder. So we have seen this address decoder in memory mapping. So there we use the decoder and we connected a 64K into 8 chips. Similarly, here you can connect the latches 74LS244 for the 8 output lines, and you can see that design here from the exam point of view, we can say it is not to that extent. Still, you can see here this address decoder is connected, output of this address decoder is connected to 7237 chip. 8259 chip, 8253 timer, 8255 programmable peripheral interface, like this various chips it is connected. So this is the IO address decoding in IBM PC. This diagram you have to study, IO address decoding in IBM PC.